Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Nemo says hi. Right. Well, as it's Sunday, you know where I go on Sundays by now. Off to Mum's for the day. Didn't get a roast today, but I had a nice steak and onion pie. No, steak pie. I think something like that. It was a meat pie of some sort. Some potatoes and some veg. It was quite nice, actually. Oh. The lady's bike I took over to Mum's when it was collected from there. That was a lot easier to do that, to be honest, because it was either they collected early in the morning, like at 9:30 in the morning, or late in the afternoon. So I thought, I'm going over to Mum's. It was closer for them. So, I collected it from there. I've bought my last mountain bike back from Mum's. I've just got a project frame sitting in the workshop now. And a couple of spare parts frames outside, that is it. What else have I done today? Sold all of those. I think you might be able to see them. Can I see them in the... Where are they? Somewhere over there, you know, those chicken... Lego chicken figure things. Hang on. So to try and show you across the room, I've got one there, haven't I? I've sold all 8. Sold them all in one go, actually. Someone sent me a best offer of £9.60 for all 8, which meant my profit on them would have been £1.60, which to me felt a little bit too low. And I had them up there at £3.99 each, so I sent back a counter offer, because you can do that on eBay, of £2 each. And they accepted it and paid. It was accepted pretty much straight away and paid for straight away. So, 8 chicken figures bought for £8, sold for £16. So they, tidy profit. I think my stepdad said by the time you take eBay fees out, I've probably made 80 to 85% profit. So yeah, that isn't bad at all. So I've got to box 8 of those up and post those off. I'll do that Thursday when I get paid. Because it's going to take 0 to 3 working days to transfer the cash to my bank account anyway. So, and I know from experience with PayPal, it's going to take 3 days, the longest stated. So, I might as well just leave the money in my PayPal and just post it when I get paid Thursday. Because it's going to take that length of time anyway. And it probably won't clear until like midnight Wednesday night, so when my money goes in. Oh, and I've sold the blue 24-speed mountain bike. That guy that wanted it never got back to me, even though I messaged him to see if he still wanted it. So I stuck it up on eBay yesterday. And while I was at Mum's today, I just randomly checked my emails on a piece of shit laptop that was doing my head in. It's got a serious overheat problem at the minute, and I need to sort of take it apart to fix it. But yeah, I was checking my emails and noticed I'd had an offer placed for the full £35 I put it up there for. But they can't collect until next Saturday, which kind of irks me a little bit. I'd have preferred sooner, but as Mum said, another week won't hurt because I've already kept it for a week for that guy. Their feedback checked out, A1 feedback score, so I can't fault that. So I thought, well, there's still some extra cash in my pocket at the weekend, isn't it? You know, I don't really need it right now. I've got that other boy's bike I brought home today just to, well, had to disconnect the brakes, actually undo the brake cable to release them so I can get the wheels in and out. So just got to set the back brake on, set the brakes back up, which is easy enough. Swap the back tyre because it's got paint on it, and I've got a good tyre. Well, I've got a good one over there, and I've got good ones in the cupboard out there, so that's not a problem. And just make sure the tyres are inflated, and that's good to go. And then I've just got that jump bike in the bedroom to sort out, which shouldn't take me long either, so. But what I'll do tomorrow, I'll get that. It's a rally bike, what I brought home today. Good brand. So I'll do that tomorrow, because it's only going to take me, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes just to sort that tyre and brakes out. And get that up. Or I better take that bike I've sold off. Both bikes, actually, that I've sold off of Gumtree as well. Because it'll be sod's law now that I'll get bombarded with messages. Have you still got the bike? Nope, sold. And the way I see it, as annoying as it will be for me to keep getting the messages, it's probably annoying for other people when no one replies because they've sold the bike. So I like to delete my ads when I'm done with them. I think after a certain period of time they automatically delete anyway, but I'd rather do it myself. Nothing going on Facebook at the minute. Just check emails. All right, he's replied us. All right then. And I've got a mobile phone number as well. Who sent me? That's all right then. I don't like phoning numbers like that because I prefer to do all communication through eBay. Just like I do with Gumtree. Just because, well, one, I communicate better that way than over the phone anyway. And two, should anyone try to con me or, you know, beat me up when they get here or whatever, I've actually got the communications all logged in email, so. And the same for them. I just find it's a bit more secure. So. Because when you talk over the phone, it would be your word against theirs, wouldn't it? And even eBay says to keep all communications to their messaging system. Because I guarantee eBay system logs every message that is sent. So if there is a problem, they, you know, eBay team can access them and see for themselves. Which is fair enough. Right, I think I can delete those. Spam, was that four messages? Yeah, they are all spam. Alright, delete those. Go across to Gumtree when I can find the link. There it is. I think my French friend is absolutely right. I need to sort out my bookmarks. Because there is no sort of rhyme or reason to them. They're in sort of order as you go down the bookmark list, but I could organise them into folders and whatnot if I really wanted to. My Gumtree, manage my ads. Unfortunately, till tomorrow, there won't be anything on my Gumtree. I've got room for one more item this month on my eBay account. The guy that's collecting the bike comes from Nottingham. Nottinghamshire. Yeah, you know, it's not like a half an hour drive down the road to go and collect a bike. Fact. I'll bring Google Maps up and we'll have a look. Nottinghamshire. Yeah, that's way over in the Midlands. I'm just going to zoom out a bit. I actually can't see it. I found Manchester, Leeds, Sheffield, Birmingham. Oh, yeah, it's where the Pink District is, isn't it? Yeah, so if you look at the... I... on the way over here, pretty much there, right above my finger, near enough, and he's got to come from basically this area. Yeah, it's probably a good 4 or 5 hour drive. I just hope, well, there's Nottingham, so he's got to come from there. That would be Nottinghamshire then, that sort of area. Three, 4 hours maybe? I don't know. Should we click on directions? I'll put in my hometown. Just bear with me a sec, and I'll point the camera back at the screen. North of Ocean. There we go. Ooh, that's showing up quite a direct route there, isn't it? 2 hours, 45 minutes. Oh. That is actually as far away as I was thinking. It's still a way to come for a bike, so I'm guessing they're down for the weekend or something, because he's going to, in his message, he said he's going to contact me Friday. That was actually what I was going to ask, if he wanted my address now or wait till Friday, but he sort of answered that question before I even asked it. He must be a mind reader or something. There's another route here marked, which is 3 hours and 1 minute, which I suppose, give or take traffic, but that's 145 miles. This one, the quickest one, is 124 miles. I know someone that lives up in Grimsby up here, so... could probably drive around a bloody coast. And it looks like A17 and then on to the A148. Yeah, and then on the A140 and into North Walsham. Well, I suppose that depends on... I presume he'll use a sat nav, you know, most people do these days, so sat nav could take him in a different way, because I can actually see loads of ways when they get to King's Lynn. But that way would be the quickest. But either way, it's not as far away as I actually thought it was. A47 and A1, yeah, fuck that. That's a longer way to go. Oh, and there's one there via the A50. Oh, yeah, because the A52 comes in there. Alright, enough of that. Bye. Get off my chair, dipstick. Every time. He does this every time when I've got the camera on. Or when I'm talking on the phone. It's almost like he's jealous that I'm giving attention elsewhere and not to him. Right, let's open YouTube up. Got cola in the fridge, I believe. Fitness or Steuben, okay. One Lonely Farmer's got a video up. Vlogging Life has got one up. Autistic Genius has got his son diary up. Got one from Darren Lobb to watch. I haven't watched any from Julian Illett for a long while, so I'll have to watch some from him. Catch up. Watch some motorbike videos. 12 volt vids, I'm caught up with him. Pardon me. Ugh. Okay, so I've got some vids there I can watch. Yeah, there was a nasty railway accident today. Not fatal. And this was the other side of Norwich City, not far from Thetford. This train hit a tractor. On a level crossing, the tractor was going across a level crossing and yep, that is the one. This is Honning Church. When I was cycling back from Cat's Custom Trikes a week ago, it was getting dark. I've got a lovely illuminated crucifix at the top of that. I'm not really religious, but that was just... it did look pretty, nonetheless. Yeah, that's got the illuminated crucifix on it. Still look pretty. So much I want. I was just reading comments as well. I went quiet there, but so much I want to reply to. I'm going to wait though. I'm not going to do it on camera. Oh, get out of the way. Right. Well, that elusive brake caliper is still absent without leave. Still haven't found a bloody thing. But the inner tubes have stayed up. That's good. I pumped those up last night and they are still fully inflated. So, what I'm going to do, just to make things a bit easier and to tick one job off the list. Oh, okay, maybe not tonight. It was a bit later than I thought it was. In that case then, I'll do that tomorrow when I've got a free moment. And this one is slowly getting there. So I was tempted to put a baggage rack on this and put the panniers on it and use this as sort of like the hybrid bike, which it is, ish, sort of. I don't know, because I could always put the panniers on the electric bike as well if I really wanted to. It's gone dark. Who turned out the lights? No one, because I haven't even turned up. Can't even hit the bloody switch. Ooh, fuck. Okay. Time to move the drill out of the doorway, I think, because I just tripped over it. Yeah, this one's going to be started on at least tomorrow as well, I hope. I'll just sit on a bit. I'll go down and I'll fish that single speed crank out for this. And get that fit. That looked brand new though, that three-speed crank. Look at it. That doesn't look like it's that old, to be honest. It's quite clean and tidy. But I've got a feeling, as this was this had no gears on the front originally, the owner probably bent the single speed over doing a jump or something, or dropped it, and someone's replaced it with a three-speed. But I will revert it back to a single speed. Find a set of V-brakes up for it. Or should have. Handlebar, which I've got kicking around somewhere. Seat, not a problem. Tube, got box full because that back one's punctured. Front one pumped up and held air nicely, so it's just that back one I pumped up and it went down again. So, sort that out. Got 6-speed grip shift hanging up here somewhere. I did actually hang it on the bike. I think it fell off. Did it? No, it's not that one. Got another use for that one. Got handlebar grips as well. Brake levers, that's the other one I'm going to need. I'm not fussed what they are, so long as they are for V-brakes. And actually, while we're on a subject, I'll show you what the difference is. There's a difference with brake levers, believe it or not. Now, if you notice with this lever, there's no little metal bracket on there to put the cable in. It goes into the actual lever itself. That's a non-V-brake lever, by the way. V-brake brake levers, like this one, have that little metal sort of bracket tab thing here that you put your cable in. As you notice, the cable's further back on the lever. That's the difference, and believe me, you wouldn't believe that the difference of fitting the cable here on a lever and sort of like here on a lever would make all that difference, but it does. If I tried using this brake lever on a set of V-brakes, they will be spongy as hell. So this is actually thanks to a video I watched from a bike repair guy on YouTube that I'm subscribed to. That's how I learnt that one. I always wondered why. Sometimes when I upgraded to V-brakes, the brakes would be spongy, because I never upgraded the brake levers. But that's why. And I know it's true, because as soon as I saw that, I went down and changed the brake levers on a bike that had spongy brakes, because I'd upgraded it from cantilever to V-brakes, changed the brake levers, boom, got rid of the spongy brakes. What are you being noisy for? Or I might just keep this as it is. Might actually just do it up as another mountain bike, to be honest. I've got those other mountain bike tyres. And I have two Claude Butler mountain bikes, because I'm greedy and I want to. The bit that's holding me up is I need a front derailleur. I don't have one that fits. I've got a lot that will fit standard tubing, standard sized tubing. But I haven't got one that will fit this. Could actually keep these road bearing tyres on it though. But just do it up as it is. Perhaps put mud guards on this one, because I've got a pile of them out on the landing. Including the ones that originally came off this, so I can soon chuck them back on. Because my other Claude Butler doesn't have mud guards on. On account of the back one didn't lock on properly and it kept bouncing off. It's supposed to be a clip that goes around this seat tube and it just kept bouncing off. So I took them off and I think I fitted them to another. Oh, I know what bike I put those on. I put those on the Integra. Because I think it was the gear cable that was actually getting in the way. But yeah, I've got some that I can fit on that one, hopefully. Right. Wow, 24 minutes already? Ooh. Alright then, I'm going to turn the camera off, feed Mr. Nemo. Pour myself a drink of cola, not alcohol. Ooh, hiccuped. And watch a few videos on YouTube. I don't know what else yet. Yeah. Be back in a bit. This chair is getting seriously past it. Listen. Is it going to do it now? Yeah, I think this chair is getting ever so slightly past it. I did decide to put the tubes in, so these tyres are now pumped up. And I'm going to have to change the stem, because it ceased. I cannot get this bolt, which is on the other side, to unscrew. So I'm going to have to find another stem. I did find the other day another adjustable stem, but again it's got the top cover bit missing, but I'm sure I've got something down there I can use. I know there's at least one more adjustable stem than there used to be, unless I used it. No, I don't remember using it. Oh well, I'll think of some. I will think of something. Don't know what I'll think of, but I'll think of something. Right. Oh, both tires do have the reflective strip around the edge. I don't know if you can see that white band around the tyre. That's actually a reflective strip. It's a bit worn out on this back tyre, I think, in a place, but there's no cracking on the tyres, and you know, it's still good tread. They are road tyres after all. They're both made by Schwalbe. So Schwalbe Marathon. What's this one? That's a Marathon Plus, so I've got a Marathon and a Marathon Plus. Not actually the tyres I was looking to put on this, but I thought I had some different ones, but they're not down in the shed, so yeah, either I've used them or I was imagining things. Doesn't matter what these ones on there, they'll do. They're good enough. Not an exact match, but close enough. Oh dear. Right. Pretty certain Nemo's got food in his dish. Yep. Oh yeah, out of all the LED lighting I've got, the bulb in this one has got a bit of a delay. I'll just flick the switch. Do you see that? It's faster once it's been on, but when it's cold and you first turn it on, there's like a second delay between you hitting the switch and the actual bulb lighting. Well, it's not a problem, it's just a random observation. It's the only LED bulb I've got that does it. Right, so what have I got to do tomorrow? Change tyre on that boy's bike, sort the brakes out, get that up. Then no, I'm not going to do anything to this one, not unless I find that epoxy brake lever, caliper, whatever it fucking is, I don't care anymore. I'm just doing my head in. I know it's flipping here somewhere. Start work on the one in the bedroom. If it's nice, I'll take it downstairs and work on it out there. that and the crank and everything I want is actually outside. And I think it's actually going to be pretty nice when that's done. Yeah, I suppose while I'm outside tomorrow, I should fit that to the bike as well, shouldn't I? Bloody useful. I've got a blue stem in there, but that's horrible. I don't even know why I keep that, to be honest. I can't even remember what's in that box either. Wind's picking up in here, isn't it? At some point tomorrow as well, I'm going to see if I can arrange some interwebs over this end somehow. I haven't quite figured out how yet. I think what I'll do, I'll use one of my little blue ones and put up there. I'm going to take these extension cords over to the to Mum's and put in the workshop. Out of my friggin' way. I'm coming useful for something, but not here. actually, speaking of electrical, I can't remember if I've shown these before, because I can't remember if it was on the footage I accidentally deleted, but I've got a couple of these adapters here to have a bit of light on the subject. A friend of mine was chucking these out when he was moving out of his flat, so I've got this one, which is British to Euro, so if I was going to, I don't know, France, Germany, or anywhere in Europe, I would take this, because then I could plug anything, the standard British plug into it, because the voltage is exactly the same, and the frequency, it's 50 hertz as well, so wouldn't make any difference. 7.5 amp, I thought I said 75 amp, I was like, fucking hell, I can take a large amount of current. Simple two prongs. Then I found this one. And I've actually realised that this end, it's an Australian plug. So if I was going to see relatives in Australia, I could take this with me. If I was going to take any of my own electrical doodads, like a shaver, because I believe they're on the same voltage as we are as well. But on this one, you can actually plug multiple different plugs into this. It's got your standard British 3-pin plug connectors there. And then it's got the US connectors as well. It's got USA there and there. I'm not sure if that's the earth pin for an American plug. I don't know what that is. I think it is, actually. I'm pretty certain it is. But there is a warning on this one that says, do not use in UK. And I think the reason for that is because, even though it will fit like that, the problem is you could easily reverse polarity by accidentally plugging it in upside down. However, you shouldn't. If you've got a compliant outlet, British outlet, be able to plug it in anyway. I mean, I can try. Oh, that won't go in, look. Because it's got the shutters on. So if you've got an older outlet without the shutters, then yes, you could. And not all trailing outlets actually have them. I have noticed that. Not all of them have the shutters. That one has. There's some really cheapy ones that don't, which probably wouldn't be compliant anyway. I don't know why I keep these. I mean, the chances of me going abroad is slim. I'm not going to say never going to happen, because you never know what's going to happen, but I will keep hold of those. But yeah, I can't believe I've got an Aussie one here as well. Corjo. Total loading, 10 amp, 250 volt AC. Which actually puzzles me as to why it's got a US connector on it. Because USA voltage is 110 to 120-ish, somewhere around there. So, you know, you can plug that into a socket over here, or in Australia, you're going to blow up your device. Unless you use a special converter thingy, transformer thingy, to drop the voltage to the USA voltage. Bloody hell. Right. Well, suppose I could, if I get a chance, I'll pack those up tomorrow out of the way as well. Get ready for Thursday. Right. You know, I don't really want the stem up at that height, so I was going to drop it, but it won't let me. It's not rusty or anything, so I don't know if it's just been done up insanely tight, but it felt like if I'd used any more force, I was going to snap the hexagon key, so yeah. I might give it one more try tomorrow. I might just soak it in a bit of WD-40 and see if that helps. Because you never know, it might. Right. So I was just thinking about that brake that I can't find. It's driving me up the wall now. I know it's here. I know for a fact it's here. Never mind. It'll turn up. I don't need it right this minute, do I? I mean, I can't even sort any cables out anyway. And at least we're sitting on two inflated tyres now, so it'll be easier to roll it around, and I won't damage the tyres either. Because if you leave a bike on a flat tyre long enough, you can bend the tyre out of shape, and that'll just cause extra arseache. So even if I'm not using a bike, I do like to keep them on inflated tyres. Oh, forks definitely look alright in there. They look better than I thought they would. I was unsure when I first bought those home. But, yeah, they're looking good. Looking good. What have I got the cowgirl out here? What's she doing up there? All my figures should be in the figure tray. So either there's a ghost in here that keeps moving my figures around, or they come alive when I go to bed. I haven't figured out which yet. Either that or I'm just going completely fucking gaga. But I've got bike parts going missing, and I've got Lego figures moving around the flat, so you decide. It'd be nice if I had all the parts to finish this, you know. But I don't. Can't even put I can actually change the freewheel. I've noticed the bearings have gone in the actual freewheel, not the wheel, the freewheel, the gears, because it wobbles and it's not meant to wobble. So it's probably worn out anyway, but I want a 7-speed on there, so I'm going to change it. I might see one under here. What speed is that? Is that coincidentally a 7-speed laying here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it is. It's not a very clean and tidy one. I think I've got a better one down in the thing, and this one's seized up anyway. The freewheel doesn't freewheel. That's not a lot of use. You need a freewheel that freewheels. It's salvageable, because I can see it rocking back and forth, so a bit of WD-40 in there, that might free it off. Who knows? I don't have many 7 speeds, so I might salvage it, but I know I've got a good working one down in the shed, which I will use. Bring it up here. I've got to re-grease the axles on at least the front wheel. I can't remember the back wheel, but I can do. It'd be easier to do that on the wheels and get the wheels done before I put the chain and anything on. So I suppose I can get the grease gun out and do that tomorrow as well. Don't think I need to touch the bottom bracket, do I? No. That's all spinning nicely. Pedals are spinning nicely. I've got the end chipped on that one, but I'm not selling it and that doesn't bother me, so. Well, actually, I do have a better pair of pedals downstairs that I might put on it because I prefer the shape. That's the only reason I'd change them. If not, I'll probably just leave these ones on. Right. Sold that lady's bike for £20 today, and that's what I've got left, and I haven't even spent anything on me yet. Why? Because I'm such a nice son to my mum, I bought her a packet of ciggies. Because I'm a nice boy. I've got a bit of loose change. Not a lot. Most of those can go in my... I think most of that change can actually go into my change pot out of the way. It's not worth keeping that in my pocket. Well, I've got £20 in my PayPal account, but like I said, that's going to take 3 working days to appear in my bank account, so we can't be bothered with that. That can stay there. Because my plan is, whatever I make on eBay that gets paid via PayPal will stay in PayPal. And that will be like my savings account. So I'm going to save that for a little while and see what I can get. Mainly because I can't be asked to wait 3 days to transfer it across. So I think I'm going to try those instructions as well. I've got a bike frame. I've got a few bits I could stick up there, to be honest. That instruction manual, because it's for a very... I don't know if it's a rare set, but it's an expensive set to buy. That manual's not in mint condition, but if someone wants an original manual here, or a Bible, as a Swedish guy I watch on YouTube calls them, the Holy Bible of Lego, I'll try it. I'll start it at 99p because I ain't got a friggin' clue what it's worth, if anything. But I know if someone wants to complete a set that they haven't got the instructions for, then they'd probably go for it. But I doubt I'll get a lot for it because I've had to tape the cover bit back on. But, apparently that was a very expensive set when that was new. And still is worth a fair bit of cash. That reminds me, I've got some bits as well. With the power puller stickers on, so... I don't know if they're going to be worth anything. I might. Instead of putting them on eBay, I could try them on the UK Lego for Sale group. I can't remember the exact. Is it Lego for Sale Swap Wanted UK? That's the name of the Facebook group. Good group. I've done trades at least once on there, but I actually have to say, when it comes to for sale groups on Facebook, I don't pay attention to them anymore. Reason being, I know this is going to turn into quite a long video, but I don't care. The reason I don't really use the for sale groups on Facebook is I've noticed that it's always the same people buying and selling, actually. And if you are not... Why is this camera focusing on the shelf there with the face tracking square? I have no idea. But yeah, I've noticed that you get the same people... Or you get the same people that are always... It's like they watch the for sale groups like a fucking hawk to get the bargains before anyone else does. So unless you yourself sit there on Facebook all day watching these for sale groups like a hawk, waiting for bargains to be put on that you can pounce on immediately, you ain't gonna get nothing. The other reason is I actually find it difficult to sell because there's so many Facebook groups out there that you can sell on. I mean, there's hundreds in my area of Norfolk alone. Because obviously I'll go to other local groups like Cromer, Munsley, and whatever else surrounds this town, Norwich City, you know, as well as the sort of dozen or more that's for this town as well that people have set up. And I find it hard to keep track on where I've posted. I don't always get notifications through when someone comments on a for sale post. So I gave up with that. I just found it too difficult. It'll be all right if you stuck to like one or two groups, but yeah, I just decided to stick with what I know best, basically, eBay and Gumtree. They work, I've stuck with them. Anyway, I'm just going to check my emails again, make sure I haven't got nothing through. Inbox is empty from the look of it. So is my spam box. Ooh, quiet night. That makes a change. Yeah. With that blue bike I sold, I wasn't wanting to accept it because I wanted it ideally collected before the weekend. But... Mum was actually right in saying, you know, someone else could come along with an offer and it'll be less than what they were offering. They were offering full price. They want to pay full price, so I'm getting the full £35 for it. It is clattering up my shed, you know. I've got that bike I brought home today I've had to put outside because I can't get it in the shed. So it's locked round back. Could do with a trip to the recycle centre this weekend. See if I can grab anything. Or even during the week. Like Thursday when I get paid. If I can get... I don't know. Mum to pick me up after work on Thursday. Then... hopefully we can stop over at the recycle centre, because I'm running out of stock now. Not necessarily parts, well, certain parts I am, but... I know Biggles has got a mountain bike he wants the grip shifts off of. The cat has just done a crap in the tray. Isn't it nasty? That reminds me as well, I've got to empty his tray and clean it out. Anyway. I completely lost the thread in what the heck I was talking about now. I might need to go poopy as well, so... If the cat wants competition, he's got competition, but I know I'll win. Oh dear. Still got a stupid TV cabinet on the landing I want to get rid of. Cancel that. Brr. Right. Tickly nose now. What is it when you got your hands full, you get a tickly nose or an itch? every time you got your hands full. Oops. Right, that's that website sorted. Nearly forgot to do my rounds, as it were. That's a lot. I'll come back to that one then. Right. Facebook gone dead, no surprise there. Oh yeah, that reminds me as well. One of the high school teachers has been dubbed the Gorilla Gardener in town because he goes around and he's gardened a lot of wasteland areas and made them look nice. With landowners' permission, of course. There's one just up the road up that way, just, I don't know, about 100 yards from me, about that, on the actual road over there. Anyway, some lady, woman, I don't know how old she was, but just a woman stopped him today and complained that someone she knows, with the fence that borders this particular bit of land up there, has just had to spend £350 replacing a fence that blew over in the wind. All because, allegedly, he'd pulled out brambles that were supporting the fence. In fact, he left the brambles on the fence panels that he was asked to leave them on, because they were propping up the fence. And there was no brambles on the fence panels that fell over. He didn't remove any because there wasn't any there. I think it's a bit of a daft thing to complain about, because I've seen the fence down there and I've actually thought to myself, you know, it's rotten as shit, it needs replacing. And if weeds are the only thing that's actually keeping the fence up, then it's a good hint that the fence is fucked and needs to come down and be replaced anyway. So, it's just like this person was pissed off because they had to spend money to replace or repair a rotten fence that was going to come down regardless of the brambles being there or not. So, you know, and why should the rest of the town be forced to look at a total fucking eyesore because someone is too tight-fisted to get their fence fixed? Just saying. I mean, that fence actually looks like it's been there about 100 fucking years. It's about time it was replaced. They keep having this mid-month farmer's market in town, though, but they're not advertising it. I'm not seeing it advertised. Never mind. Du-du-du. David Cameron really is in the light at the minute for all his tax dodging. Fucking hell. Rather them than me. Just watching a video where they'd Got this easel set up with, you know, all the paper on it, and beside that, on a raised part of the garden, so it was level with the easel, they tilted a lawnmower back, started it up, and, you know, it was a gas lawnmower, started it up so it was running, and they're throwing paint cans into the blades. So, of course, when the blades hit it, they explode and just splash paint all over the canvas as well as everything else. So the random scroll. I do want another Lego Technics set. I did enjoy building me digger. Ow! What the fuck are you doing? Don't you talk back to me, bastard. He stuck his claws into my leg for no reason. Share if you think I should resign. No, I think you should be fired into space. Ouch. Motorcyclist dies after collision with a fire engine. Well, I think I'm going to call it quits. So thanks for watching. And if you like the video, then please feel free to hit the like button. Feel free to comment and feel free to subscribe. I'll talk to you all later. Might find the thingy button.